Okay, now previously we discussed the time and distance concept, that is from the average, from basics to average. Now let's have a discussion on the relative speed concept also. Relative speed, this is most important concept for getting the problems in trains, okay, and some problems in the time and distance, and some more problems in races also. In a circular track moving position, in a circular track moving opposite direction, in a circular track moving the same direction, in that case also relative speed concept here. Okay, relative speed concept arises if and only if when the two objects are in moving position only. Relative speed concept arises if and only if when the two objects are in moving position. If they are moving in the same direction with different speeds, that there the relative speed is equal to, it's looking like a multiple symbol, right? So x minus y, where x is the fastest speed and y is the small speed, x kilometers per hour and y kilometers per hour. This is the relative speed. Okay, relative speed is nothing but the speed when the two objects moving with the different speeds. Comparative speed, relative speed means a comparative speed of the two objects. Well, if they are moving in the same direction, relative speed is equal to difference of the speeds. Because let's take an example. Suppose a thief snatches a chain at a point A, okay, and he runs at a speed of, okay, and he runs at a speed of, suppose 4 kilometers per hour or 10 kilometers per hour. He runs at a speed of 10 kilometers per hour, and after half an hour policeman identify that and start chasing from the point A with a speed of, policeman chasing at a speed of, here it is, 20 kilometers per hour or 15 kilometers per hour. Then in how many minutes or how many hours the policeman can catch the thief? Okay, in this case thief is at this point, he is also moving in same direction. Policeman starts at this point with a speed of 15 kilometers per hour, and thief also running at a speed of 10 kilometers per hour. Those two objects are in moving position. Here in how many minutes then a policeman can catch the thief? Okay, initially this is the starting point. After half an hour, policeman identify that. After half an hour, thief can run 5 kilometers. Okay, this is the starting variation, starting distance between policeman and the thief. Okay, this distance will be reduced only because of the additional speed run by the policeman. Am I right? Okay, this distance can be reduced only because of which one speed? Policeman additional speed. Okay, so policeman additional speed is, actually he is also in moving position, he is also moving position. If thief is also running at a speed of 10 kilometers per hour and policeman also running at a speed of 10 kilometers per hour, there is no choice of getting the thief. Okay, when, okay, if policeman runs at the speed of 15 kilometers per hour, what is the additional speed run by the policeman in 1 hour? 5 kilometers. Okay, so here the relative speed is 5 kilometers per hour. That means the distance between policeman and the thief at the initial also 5 kilometers. That means 5 kilometers was traveled in 1 hour. That means the policeman can catch the thief in 1 hour by getting the GPS signals. Okay, right. So in 1 hour the policeman can catch the thief. This can be identified only because of the relative speed concept. Okay, if I start from Hyderabad, okay, and another person starts from Vijayawada or Vizag. A person starts from Vizag and I am starting from Hyderabad. Okay, that person gets the paper sweet for me. Okay, if a person gets the paper sweet for me with a speed of 120 kilometers per hour, and I am moving with a speed of
here it is 80 kilometers per hour.
And the total distance from Hyderabad to Vizag is around 800 kilometers. Okay, then in how many minutes or how many hours they can meet each other? In how many hours they can meet each other? In first hour he travels 120 kilometers, in first hour he travels 80 kilometers. Then totally how many kilometers they can travel? Okay, here it is, the relative speed is nothing but the addition of the two speeds. Okay, when they are moving in the opposite direction with the speed of x kilometers per hour and y kilometers per hour, then relative speed is nothing but, when they are moving in opposite direction, it's looking like a plus. Okay, x plus y kilometers per hour. So in this case, in first hour he covers 120 distance, he covers 80 kilometers distance. Okay, in the second hour he covers 120, he covers 80. So per hour they all together covers 20 kilometers. Here the relative speed is equal to 200 kilometers. Relative speed is equal to 200 kilometers per hour. That means 200 kilometers was covered in 1 hour. Okay, then 800 kilometers was covered in how many hours? 800 by 200 hour, you can get 4 hours. That means after 4 hours they can meet each other at a certain point in between Hyderabad and Vizag. Okay, now here after 4 hours, 4 into 80 240 kilometers was over, and 12 fours 48, 480 kilometers was over. 480 plus here 18 to 4 is 240. Okay, here it is 12 fours 48. After 4 hours he can travel 12 fours 48 480, here it is 240. Then total it is 6, and here it is 320 plus 480, then you can get 800 kilometers on the total. We can meet at a certain point. By basing upon this relative speed concept, he gives the questions in the trains also, in the general time and distance also. Okay, in circular track also they are moving in the opposite direction, they are moving in the same direction, when they will meet at the first time, when they will meet at the starting point at the first time, like that questions will be given. Okay, now let's take another model of example. Here the conclusion in relative speed is, when the two objects are in moving position only, relative speed concept arises. And another concept is, when the two objects moving in the same direction, the relative speed of the two objects is the difference of the two speeds. Okay, and the relative speed of the two objects when they are moving in the opposite direction is sum of the two speeds. Okay, now the another concept is, suppose for example without stoppages a train travels, without stoppages a train travel with a speed of 100 kilometers per hour, and with stoppages it can travel on an average of 80 kilometers per hour or 60 kilometers per hour. Okay, then what is the stoppage time per hour? This model is very very important to you. Without stoppage a train travels at a speed of 100 kilometers per hour, and with stoppages it can travel at a speed of 60 kilometers per hour on an average. Okay, and stoppage time per hour is, in this case a stoppage time per hour means the stoppage is only because of this reduced speed. Okay, here this is by the slower one only you can get the stoppages, right? That means here our base is highest one, 100 kilometers was traveled in 1 hour. Okay, 1 hour means 60 minutes. In 60 minutes then 40 kilometers was traveled in how many minutes? Okay, 100 kilometers was traveled in 60 minutes. Okay, then I am asking you stoppage time per hour.
Stoppage time per hour generates from
which one? This one, by this one, without stoppage, train travels with a speed of 100 kilometers per hour. With stoppage, it can travel only 60 kilometers per hour. That variation arises only because of the stoppages.
Okay.
Now, so for 40 kilometers per hour, it is 40 by 100 into 60 minutes. Then while you cancel this one, you can get the answer 24 minutes. That means for every 24 minutes, the train has the stoppages. That means for 1 hour, how many stoppages there? Only 2. Okay, only 2. 24 plus 24, 48. After 24, it crosses the 1 hour. So we have 2 stoppages. Okay, and for every 24 minutes, this is nothing but this is difference of the speeds. Let the difference of the speeds here, it is the x and this is the y. Okay, x minus y by x into 60 minutes is nothing but stoppage time per hour. This is the formula. Based upon the formula also you can do the answer, or if you very much gather about this concept, then 100 kilometers based upon the speed one only, you can calculate that variation of that 40 kilometers time. So 100 kilometers was traveled in 60 minutes, then 40 kilometers was traveled in 24 minutes based upon the conditions. Okay, I will give another model. Repeatedly asked in the questions in the examination, that is, if a person moving with a speed of 30 kilometers per hour, okay, he can reach his office by with a speed of 30 kilometers per hour, he can reach his office from his house by 10 minutes late. Okay, and when he moving with a speed of 40 kilometers per hour, he can reach his office, or here it is 50 kilometers per hour, he can reach his office by 10 minutes early. Then what is the average time? Okay, what is the average time and the what is the distance from his house to office is the question. Okay, by traveling with a speed of 30 kilometers per hour, he is late by 10 minutes. By traveling with a speed of 15 kilometers per hour, he is early by 10 minutes. Okay, to reach at the right time, that is the neutral point, that is 40 kilometers per hour is the speed. Okay, this can also be done in the examinations. If you ask what is the real speed has to be more to reach the office right time. Okay, in this case, you can do the problem in two ways. So d1 is equal to d2. When you equalize, the distances are same, that why d1 is equal to d2. What is the distance formula? Distance is equal to speed into time. So 30 kilometers per hour into here it is 10 minutes late. If the actual time is x, okay, here the time is 10 minutes late. Okay, here the actual time is x, here it is 10 minutes late. That's why addition takes place. Okay, now 50, here it is 50 kilometers, when he travels with a speed of 15 kilometers per hour, then he reaches his office 10 minutes early. If the actual time is x, this is actual time. Actual time is equal to x. Okay, so x minus 10. Okay, when you apply this one, kilometers per hour cancel, 0, 0 cancel. Then 3x plus 30 minutes is equal to 5x minus 50. Okay, 5x minus 50 minutes. Okay, then finally it is 2x is equal to 80 minutes. Then x is equal to 40 minutes. When you are aware of the speed and the time, you can get the answer very easily. Suppose this is the right time. When he travel with a speed of 30 kilometers per hour, he is late that by 10 minutes. Then actual time plus minute time, this is 50 minutes. 40 plus 10, this is the time and this is the speed. Then distance is equal to, what is the formula here? Here distance is equal to speed into time his speed is 30 kilometers per hour.
Okay,
that means 30 kilometers per hour. By applying the unitary method, 30 kilometers was traveled in 1 hour. That means 60 minutes. In 50 minutes, it can travel 30 into 50 by 60. Zeros cancel, 6 ones and 6 fives, you can get 25 kilometers is the distance from the office to
house and house to office.
Okay, you can do like this also, or sometimes another clue is distance is equal to LCM of the speeds, LCM of the speeds into here late time plus actual time, total time taking for the late and the early. That means as he moves by late, he is 10 minutes late. That means he takes additional, he takes minus of minus 10.
Okay, he is early by, he is saving 10 minutes. He is saving 10 minutes. Okay, he is late by 10 minutes. That means that difference should be considered.
Okay, in number line to get it at the right position. It is the 10 minutes early portion, this is the 10 minutes late portion. Okay, to get at the neutral point, you should have to 10 minus of minus 10 should be taken. So here it is, LCM of the speeds is nothing but here LCM of 30 kilometers per hour and 50 kilometers per hour into 20. Okay, 20, what is this? Minutes. You should have to consider about this one. 30 and 50, what is the LCM for this one? Highest number multiple common to all. 52 is 100. 100 is not common to 30. 53 is 150. 150 is common to this one. So 150 kilometers in 1 hour per hour into 20 minutes. 20 minutes is nothing but 20 minutes is nothing but, okay, 20 by 60, that is 1/3 hour. Hour per hour cancel. You can get 3 ones and here 3 fives and 0.
Okay, you can get the distance directly. Okay, by this way, you can get the answer very easily.
Okay, so here is the answer for you. And in trains, we are using the same concept of time and distance. Now it is the trains, but only the simple concept here is to, in order to form a stationary man or a tree or any object, a train has to cover the distance. Okay, assume this is a train. Okay, in order to cross a pole or a tree or a man, stationary man, okay, in order to cross the stationary man, a train has to cover the total distance is equal to what? Train length. Distance is equal to what? Train length. Suppose, assume this is a pole. Assume this is a pole and this is a train. In order to cross this pole, a train has to cover the total distance of the train. Okay. Then only the train can cover that pole and it can cross that pole. That means distance is equal to what? Train length in that condition. Okay. In order to cross a bridge or a platform or a tunnel, assume this is a bridge. Okay. And assume this is a train. Okay. Assume this is a train. In order to cross a bridge or a platform or a tunnel or any other top length more than 1 meter, that means the wheel length of the train is 1 meter. So in order to cross the bridge or platform or a tunnel or any other top length more than 1 meter, a train has to cover the distance equal to this length and the train length. Suppose assume this is the bridge. Assume this is the bridge. In order to cross the bridge, a train has to cover this distance of the bridge, and in order to cross this one, okay, in order to cross this one, it has to cover the distance of the train also. Suppose this is the bridge, okay, this end to this end, okay, this is the bridge, okay, and this is the train. In order to cross this bridge, a train has to cover the total distance of the bridge and as well as the train length here.
if it crosses the decimal, the ending point of that bridge, then only it is said to be the, it crosses the bridge or platform. That means in order to cross the bridge or the platform or any object of length more than 1 meter, distance has to be covered is train length plus bridge length or platform length. Okay, by this case only we can follow the conditions. Suppose for example a train crosses a stationary man, in suppose for example 20 seconds, okay, and runs at a speed of, suppose for example 36 kilometers per hour, okay, then what is the train length? Then train length is equal to question mark. Okay, in this case, a train has to cross the man. Okay, here train length is equal to the distance and time is equal to what he has given, 20 seconds, speed is equal to 36 kilometers per hour. That means 36 kilometers was traveled in one hour, that means in 60 minutes. But the time is in seconds, that's why you should have to convert this one as 3600 seconds. Okay, and this kilometers to meters. Okay, when you cancel this one, you can get double zeros cancel and 36 ones and 36 tens. That means in 1 second it can travel 10 meters. That in 20 seconds it can travel how many second, how many meters? 200 meters. That 200 meters is nothing but the distance. This 200 meters is nothing but the distance. This distance is equal to train length. Okay. This distance is equal to what? Train length. Okay. I'll give another example to you. Suppose a train crosses a platform. A train crosses a platform of length 100 meters in 36 seconds, in 20 seconds, with a speed of 36 kilometers per hour. Then what is the train length? In this case also you are doing the same thing, but at the final you can conclude that distance is including of the both train and the bridge. Okay, here the speed is equal to what? 36 kilometers per hour. It can be converted into 36 into 5 by 18 meters per second. Sometimes 18 ones and 18 twos, you can get 10 meters per second. That means 10 meters was traveled in 1 second. This is another shortcut. Okay, in 1 second it can travel 10 meters. In 20 seconds it can travel 20 into 10, that is 200 meters. In this 200 meters, in this case, it has two things, that is train length and the bridge length or the platform length. Here he gives the platform length as 100. So this balancing figure is equal to what? 100. That is nothing but the train length. Okay, by the same way I will give to you in so many problems to you. Okay, right? Using the relative speed concept, one train starts from the Hyderabad, one train starts from Vizag or the Chennai, like that. Okay, and I will give the time or the speed. Okay, what are the second train speed if it crosses like that, if it crosses within a time. Okay, like that problems will be given from the trains. Okay, and let's have a discussion on the boats and streams. Okay, boats and streams. In this case, when you are aware of these formula concept, it is easy to solve the questions. First look at here, assume the boat speed as x kilometers per hour and the water speed is the man speed or boat speed still in water
That means in still water that speed is. In the water speed or the current speed or current. Current speed or the stream. Stream may be the speed. Okay, the water speed or the current speed is y kilometers per hour. Assume that one. Then downward stream means here you should have to know what two dialogues, downward stream and upward stream. Stream means speed. Okay, downward stream and upward stream. Upward stream. Okay, here downward stream is nothing but ds, upward stream is nothing but es. Downward stream means the man moving along with the direction of the water. The man moving along with the direction of the water. This is the water direction and this is the man or the boat direction. Boat direction. Okay. The direction of the man and the water are in the same direction. That means when they are moving along with the direction of the water, the man speed increases because of the water speed pushed from the back side. Okay. So the man speed is increases because of the water speed. So downward stream means the sum of the man speed and the water speed. Okay. X plus Y kilometers per hour. In upward stream, when I move opposite to the direction of the water speed, suppose it is water and this is a boat. And a man or boat moving opposite to the direction of water, there arises some opposition through the man speed. That means man speed is reduces only because of the water. So x minus y kilometers per hour. Okay, downward stream is equal to what? X plus y. Upward stream is equal to what? X minus y. Okay, am I clear? The man speed or boat speed is assumed as x kilometers. Here our assumption. Okay, if man speed and the boat speed, then downward stream and upward stream. Okay, when you are aware of the man speed and the water speed, to get the downward stream, that means moving along with the direction of the water, that means water speed increases the man speed. That's why we can take it as addition. Okay, now I will give another one, given that downward stream and the upward stream, then what is the man speed? If you have in the problem, if you have downward stream and upward stream, what is the man speed? Okay, you can solve by this way also. Downward stream is equal to, let it be x plus y, upward stream is equal to x minus y. First equation and the second equation. When you solve these two, you can get 2x is equal to downward stream plus upward stream. Okay, then x is equal to what? Downward stream plus upward stream by 2. This is nothing but, x is nothing but what? Man speed. So when you have downward stream, if you have downward stream and upward stream, then man speed is equal to what? Downward stream plus upward stream by 2. Okay, the boat stream or water speed or current speed, water speed or current speed is equal to y. How can you get the y from this one? Downward stream, let downward stream is equal to x plus y, upward stream is equal to x minus y. When you subtract these two, okay, you can get here minus x plus x cancel and plus y 2y is equal to downward stream minus upward stream. That's why y is equal to what? Downward stream minus upward stream by 2. This is the concept. So to get the water speed, when you have the downward stream and upward stream, downward stream minus upward stream by 2 is the direct shortcut for getting the answer. Okay, when you have the man speed and the boat, man speed or boat speed and the water speed, to get the downward stream, you should have to add that one. To get the upward stream, you should have to subtract that one, water speed. Okay, if you have downward stream and upward stream, to get the man speed, downward stream plus upward stream by 2. To get the boat's water speed, downward stream minus upward stream by 2 is the answer here. Okay, in this case, if I give another one, a person moves from A to B in the water. Okay, if you travel with a speed of x kilometers per hour and return at a speed of y kilometers per hour. Okay, he moves at a speed of x kilometers per hour in onward. Okay, and he moves in the return y kilometers per hour in the return. Okay, then the time taken
for all this journey is T, then what is the total distance covered by him, A to B to B to A? Simple way, distance, here distance is equal to what? Average speed, speed into time. Here what speed? Average speed, onward and return. So average speed into time. Okay, actual distance is equal to formula is speed into time, right? So here what speed it is? Average speed. So you should have to convert the average speed. If you have the relative speed into time. So here average speed of this one is 2xy by x plus y, okay, into t. Distance, total distance is equal to 2xy by x plus y t. Okay, this come under the time and distance concept. If he gives man speed is, in this case, man speed is equal to x, water speed is equal to y, then either of the, in case of either A to B or B to A, in that cases either of from these two conditions, A to B to B to A, you have one is downward stream and another one is upward stream. Let it be onward is the downward stream, upward is the upward stream, return is the upward stream, and the total time is T. Okay, this is the data and this is the answer. Then total distance is equal to question mark in this condition. Okay, total distance covered by him, total distance is equal to D. You should have to identify this one. Total distance is equal to question mark. Here actually distance is equal to formula speed into time. Here total distance is equal to average speed into time. Here the average speeds are x plus y and x minus y are the two different speeds. Okay, so average speed is 2xy by, that means 2x plus y is one speed and x minus y is another speed. Okay, by the addition of these two, x plus y plus x minus y into t, you can get yy cancel and you can get here 2 into x square minus y square by 2x. And you cancel these two into t, you can get the answer. That means total distance from A to B and B to A is, A to B and B to A is x square minus y square by x into t. Okay, this is the total distance covered by, that means A to B and B to A. Then what is the distance from A to B? Distance from A to B is half of total distance. Okay, that means total distance by 2. That means x square minus y square by 2x into t. By using this, you can get the answers. And these are about the boats and streams. And thank you for watching these videos. Thank you very much. Have a nice time to all. Bye bye.